talking about here.
So, I believe that maybe some of you are more attracted to using ultrasound, but it's important to do. So, our objectives today would be about the course selection, user types, user linear, curvilinear, how to choose which type to open in order to conduct my scan. The scanning plan, what is the difference between transverse and longitudinal scanning? The ultrasound views, what are the different between short and long axis? And the tissue echogenicity, how to define bone cartilage vessels and fasten nerves over the ultrasound. Last thing we are going to address in this lecture would be the needle advancement. What does it mean by implant or outplant? This maybe would be an interactive lecture, so I'm anticipating that you are going to interact with me. Okay? First of all, how to select my probe. We have mainly in MSK, not to speak of, two kinds of probes, the curvilinear and the linear. The curvilinear, it gives a convex shape image on the ultrasound, and it gives a wider probe. The linear probe gives a narrow image on the ultrasound and a smaller view. So that is the linear probe. Here you can see the ultrasound beams going parallel to each other. And we have here a narrow view, a smaller view. So from this image, how can I know that I'm using the linear probe? This is a linear, a line here with about image. So this means that I'm using a linear probe. Okay, linear probe is intended for superficial structures, because it has narrow image, so it gives better resolution. So here from this image, just seeing the image, I can know, okay, this guy is using a linear probe. This is the first thing I need to identify. The second thing, this is a curvilinear probe. Here we can see it gives a wider view. A wider view, it means that it can gives more penetration. So the superficial structures, I can see it well with the curvilinear probe. However, the deeper structure, it would be very obvious using the curvilinear probe. Okay, so from the ultrasound picture, how can I identify that this is a curvilinear probe? As you can see, this is a curved shape. So this is a curvilinear probe. Okay, this is the first thing in order to know what I'm using, whether a linear or a curvilinear. So again, the linear probe is high frequency transducer probe, and it gives a better spatial. I can identify two points in the same beam, in the same direction. So if I'm here's the beam, I can identify doctor and doctor. So this is the axial resolution. I can see that there are two persons sitting in front of me, not one person. So using the linear probe, it means that I can easily identify the axial. Gives better axial resolution. It means I can see two structures in front of each other. Okay. It gives also a better lateral resolution. What does it mean by lateral resolution? It means that I can identify two structures beside each other. So if I'm here as a beam, I can see that there are two doctors sitting beside each other. Okay? So this is the lateral resolution. So with the linear probe, I have the advantage to give a better spatial resolution, which means better axial, two points in front of each other, and better lateral resolution. But on the expense of the penetration, I can see further than the first two rows, just the first two rows, and after this, I can see. So this is the linear probe. So what if I have a deeper structures? What should I select? Curvilinear probe, because curvilinear probe is a low frequency probe. It means that it can penetrate tissues deeper. So we can see here, this is a lower frequency probe, linear probe. No tissue attenuation. Tissue attenuation, it means the resistance of the tissues towards ultrasound waves. So it's lower frequency, so it can penetrate the tissues to reach the back row. That's the curvilinear probe with the lower frequency. With the higher frequency probe, with the linear probes, it gives a better spatial resolution. I can see the front rows very, very much, but I can't see the back rows. So these are the difference between the linear and curvilinear probes. This is the first thing in the probe selection. So these are two pictures here. I would like you to identify for me this picture is using which kind of probe? Linear probe. How did you know? Because it's a straight line. Okay, this picture is using which kind of probe? Curvilinear, because it's a curve. Another thing is the scanning planes. What is a scanning plane? We have a longitudinal and transverse. This is scanning in relation to the body surface. So when I'm saying longitudinal, it means that I'm putting the probe in parallel to the parasternal axis. Parasternal, anything but parallel to this line, any probe direction parallel to this line, it's in the longitudinal view. Okay? Longitudinal. Any probe parallel to this line, it's in the transverse, or it's perpendicular to the parasternal axis. Okay? This is a longitudinal view, this is a transverse view. Okay. So, in this picture, this is the kind of scanning plans. Transverse, because it's perpendicular. If I'm taking a line, intersecting, it would be perpendicular to the parasagittal axis. Okay, and this one? It's a longitudinal scanning plan. Okay, so this is in relation to the body from the outer side. So in relation to the image I'm seeing on the scan, on the ultrasound scan, I have also two types of views. I have the short axis and the long axis. The short axis, I can see the structure in a cut section. It's a circular structure, so I can see in a cut section. The long axis, I can see the structure in a longer section. Because our body is in a 2D dimension. So each structure inside our body, I can see. For instance, if I'm seeing a vessel, this is a vessel, and it's going like this. So if I saw with the whole length of a vessel, this is a long axis. If I see inside the vessel, so it's a short axis. Seeing inside the short axis, seeing the whole length, this is the long axis. Okay, so what is this scanning plane? This one? Transverse. And this one? Longitudinal. Okay, this is a transverse scan plane, and this is a longitudinal. Okay, so what is this ultrasound view? Which axis? Short or long axis? In relation to the vessel?
Short.
Why are you saying the short axis?
Because it's closed.
Round. The third thing we are going to address here is tissue echogenisty. What does it mean by tissue echogenisty? Ultrasound interacts with tissues in variable degrees. So if I'm a tissue and ultrasound beam is coming towards me, I have several options to do. Either I'm going to absorb all the ultrasound beam, or I'm going to reflect all the ultrasound beam, or I'm going to absorb part and reflect part. These are the three options I do have as a tissue. This term is called tissue echogenicity. It means the ability of the tissue either to reflect the beam, or to transmit the beam through the tissue. In order to get an image, I depend mainly on the reflected beam, not on the absorbed beam. In order to get an image, it just should be addressed tomorrow in the physics, but in general, in order to get a picture, I depend mainly on the reflected beam. So in terms of echogenicity, when I say a hyperechoic, it means white. Why? What does it mean white? White, it means I'm as a tissue, I reflected the majority of the beams. I reflected it towards the ultrasound. So when the ultrasound get a lot of beams, this appears as white. So what didn't divergent occur, but I didn't reflect all the beams I received. Okay, so it appears as gray, and gray we call gray in terms of ultrasound, we call it hypoechoic. As you see this lipoma, it's hypoechoic. It means that it's gray color. Look here, this is gray color, this is white color. This is hyperechoic, this is hypoechoic. The third term is anechoic. What does it mean by anechoic? It means that I'm as a tissue. What did I do? Absorb all the tissue. So the ultrasound probe in your hand, there is no ultrasound coming back to my probe. So it appears as dark structure. Here we can see the carotid artery, and it's anechoic. So it absorbs all the structure. So the three terms I want you to know: hyperechoic, white; hypoechoic, gray; anechoic, black. What about the different type of tissues? Is it a clear demarcation, white, gray, black? No, actually it's intermingling between these three colors, but these are only the three colors you are going to see on the ultrasound image. Okay, so bone, what do you think bone will do? As a bone?
The cortex will be ivory coat.
Yes.
And the rest of the bone, anechoic.
In terms of color, anechoic means
black, and a white ring.
Why would bone appear like this? Because bone, what does bone do? What does bone do? It absorbs the ultrasound, while the upper part it reflects that, proposes acoustic, something called acoustic shadow. So when I see
does it absorb, or there is no rejected from the periosteum, and there's no waves built in?
It doesn't reflect it, so it doesn't reach, and there are some.
That's what I mean. Doesn't reach.
Yeah.
So there is no absorption, right?
Some literatures say actually it's kind of sort of absorption, and that's why it causes a caustic shadow. And some literatures say no, there is no total absorption. At the end, when I see a black, it means that no ultrasound beams reaching my probe. Whether it's because of the absorption, whether it's because of the total divergence, but in the end, there is no ultrasound beam reaching my probe. Okay?
Yes.
So that's why bone will appear black. Black means anechoic, and above it, white. White means hyperechoic. Okay, what about cartilage? Cartilage would appear either black or gray. So either anechoic or hypoechoic. What about veins and arteries, as we have seen in the previous picture? Similar, a little where?
There's a fiber that curve inside the nerves also.
No, if it's if it's anechoic, if I'm talking about a nerve and it's anechoic nerve.
Only by compression.
Sorry?
Only by compression.
By compression, it would be compressible as a veil. And what else? Pulsatile, it would be pulsating. What else?
Color
Doppler, it would be either bluish color or reddish color. Actually, this color we are adjusting, it means that the flow is either coming towards the probe or coming away from the probe. Okay.